What we've done in our laboratory here, which we call the Histotripsy laboratory, is to develop a new surgical modality which is non-invasive, and it has real-time image guidance in the form of ultrasound imaging. The modality itself is a knifeless surgical approach, which the idea here is to generate some very energetic microbubbles ultrasonically. The generation of these bubbles is called cavitation, and these bubbles oscillate very rapidly and create a lot of mechanical stress on all the tissues and cells around it, and essentially mechanically fractionate these cells so that at the end of the treatment, if you look even under electron microscope, you don't see any recognizable tissue fragments. So basically what we do is generate what you might call micro or nano blenders. We can generate these in a very confined, precise volume. That ultrasonic focus acts like essentially a scalpel. The range of application for this technology is any place where we want to remove tissue at a tissue-fluid interface. We can actually either remove the tissue or drill a very precise hole through the tissue. One of the applications that we've been developing is to treat newborn infants who don't have a left ventricle. These infants only survive if you can create a flow channel in the septum between the left and right atria. The way that people do that now is to thread a very small catheter up into the heart and then essentially punch a hole in this atrial septum. And this is a very dangerous procedure with about 50% mortality. And so we've developed an approach where these newborn infants, we actually generate a hole in the atrial septum.
We've done over 100 dogs and innumerable piglet, and so we're now in the development of this technology where we want to take it into the clinic so that the pediatric surgeons can employ it.
Another application where we've founded a company called Histotripsy is the treatment of enlarged prostate, BPH. And in this application, we actually go in and homogenize the tissue around the urethra, and this homogenized tissue is actually urinated out by the patient. The whole thing is non-invasive. The alternative technology is called TURP, where a rotating blade is actually inserted, which, as you know, if you think about it, that's a procedure that no one relishes, and it's also rather bloody, and at least in the animal models that we've used, there's minimal bleeding, and we get very good results. There are many other applications. For example, breast cancer is one that we'll be developing fairly soon. Also, uterine fibroids, which is a big problem in women's health. And we're even working on ways of treating liver metastases.